You think one match makes someone the best? Huh? Is that what you think? You think one match makes a man the best? You think putting a belt around your waist one time means that you're the best? I got news for you. That doesn't mean crap. What makes you the best is coming to this ring and defending a title night after night, month after month, year after year. That's what makes you the best. And that's what I've done. I've beaten them all. Not one time, not one match, every single night. And that's why this morning, I tapped out. You're right. Yeah, I tapped out. I tapped out. Does that make you happy? Huh? Does that make you happy? I tapped out. Does it? Is that what you want? Does that make you happy? Because let me tell you something. It was 2-on-1, not 1-on-1. It took 2 men to beat me. 2, not 1. I had beaten them all. And that's why this morning when I got up, I looked at myself in the mirror and I still knew without a shadow of a doubt that I am the best at what I do, that I am the greatest professional wrestler alive today. And whether you like it or not, let me explain something to Chris Benoit. You think you won? You think you've beaten me? You're wrong. Because now, Benoit, the target is on your chest. Everybody is gunning for you. And you see this? You see this sling right here? You see this? We almost ripped my arm off last night. Sooner or later, Benoit, this sling is gonna come off. Sooner or later, I'm gonna be 100%. And then it's not gonna be 2-on-1. It's gonna be 1-on-1. It's gonna be man to man. And let me tell you what happens then. Let me tell each and every one of you.
Oh, no.
You know, I was back there listening to you run your mouth going on and on and on and on with your pissing and moaning. And finally, I just had enough. You say it takes more than one match to become the best. Well, last night at WrestleMania 20, Madison Square Garden, I beat Shawn Michaels. I beat you, Triple H. I made you tap. And I became the best.
Oh, my gosh. My legs are absolutely livid.
You talk about consistency, week after week, month after month, year after year. Well, I'll tell you what. When your arm gets better, when you think you're able to get back into this ring with me, when you think you're man enough, you do that. Because week after week, month after month, and year after year from here on in. I'm gonna kick your ass, and I'm gonna make you tap, and tap, and tap, and tap, and tap, and tap, and tap!
Who do they think he is? The world's heavyweight champion. Only Triple H's arm wasn't in his sling.
You know what? Not on your best damn day.
Well, come to think of it, today isn't my best damn day.
Tonight, since Evolution did such a fantastic job of defeating the Rock and Sock Connection last night at WrestleMania 20, tonight, Batista, Randy Orton, and the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, will face the team of Shawn Michaels and the new World Heavyweight Champion, Chris Benoit, in a handicap match!
What, tonight?
We're back live here on
Shawn
Raw.
Shawn Michaels, so why did you just save Chris Benoit from Evolution?
Protecting my investment. A healthy Chris Benoit means I'm eventually gonna get a world title match, and believe me, I deserve one. He hasn't beaten me yet, and I've beaten him. And I'll be damned if Triple H is gonna get that shot. And tonight, in the tag team match, I'm gonna protect my tag team partner, protect my investment, and make sure when it's all over with, Chris Benoit has to give HBK a world title match. And Triple H, if I have to, I'll take him out of contention for good.
And there's a tag to Benoit. Chris Benoit, the Wolverine. Pound for pound, the toughest man perhaps I've ever seen. And he just knocked down Ric Flair and Benoit. You talk about smashing.
No!
White slap into that German suplex.
You gotta be kidding me. He can't do this to a Batista, can he?
Look at the leverage. The strength and the leverage. Benoit suplex.
Look out!
300 plus pound man. The intensity of the new world's heavyweight champion.
He snapped.
Benoit climbing quickly to the top turnbuckle.
Look at
taking
him.
A chance.
Oh! Pounding his head right into the heart of Batista.
Benoit's got this match won here. There's a couple of hands.
one big 300-pound animal. Let me tell you, McFlair, I'm getting a taste of the world champion.
I'm going to tell you something. This is Benoit. He's making a believer out of me. I guarantee you that.
Triple H behind the referee's back in the ring. There's a sweet chin music.
No!
To Triple H.
No fear.
No fear. Michael just took care of the game.
He's injured. Triple H has got a dislocated shoulder.
Well, they should have stayed out of the ring then. And now Batista.
Oh, boy.
Looking to beat Benoit.
Oh, boy.
Benoit. Trying to set up the sharps here. Benoit used this effectively last night. Sweet 10 meter to Ric Flair. The sharps here on Batista.
It's locked in. Come on, Batista, fight it.
Batista,
get to the ropes.
Batista doesn't want to tap here. The 300-pound animal. He making it.
Oh, no.
Tapping. Batista tapped. Batista tapped.
Here are your winners, Shawn Michaels and Chris Benoit.
I have no worthy idea where Paulie and Orton went, but I do know this, that Chris Benoit and Shawn Michaels have overcome seemingly insurmountable odds here tonight in this handicap tag match.
Well, that's tonight. You don't know where Foley and Orton are, but we know where they'll be next Monday night. They'll be back here on Raw, maybe for their last time.
The new World's Heavyweight Champion, standing proudly in the ring with a man just as proud who wants that gold as well. But where will they end up next week? Could this be the last night we ever see these two men on Raw? We'll find out next week. Good night, everybody.
Straight.
Benoit.
Look at the power.
The guts of Benoit. Finally getting to that bottom rope. Referee Earl Hebner calling for the break, but Rhino now has weakened that lower back of Chris Benoit. It's going to adversely affect Benoit's quickness. There's no doubt about that.
I want to see the gore. I want to see Rhino. I want to see if that crippler crossface and our world champion can withstand the gore from Rhino.
Rhino could be a gore away from becoming the world's heavyweight champion, Benoit. Waist lock from behind. Benoit now.
Uh-oh.
Double leg pickup by Benoit. Now Benoit looking for a sharpshooter of his own. Could be it here. And Benoit.
Break it up. Come on.
Benoit. Hey, I can't believe it. Benoit had a cheat.
Benoit and Rhino in the ropes. Referee in good position. Calls some break. Got a good one.
Benoit was trying to use the rope for leverage.
Well, I'm not so sure about that, but
I'm certain of it.
Cloving right hand by Rhino. And Benoit fighting right back. Benoit, what a match. As good as I have ever seen in my career, the Triple Threat match. Oh, no! Triple suplex at WrestleMania.
What are you talking about? That was one of the all-time great matches in history. Oh, no!
A second German suplex as Benoit, with all that leverage, the pit bull like Benoit, with his hands clasped, the third German suplex on the 275-pound Rhino. Benoit, a proud World's Heavyweight Champion. But man, he is as tough as nails.
Things are looking down for poor Rhino here.
And Benoit now going to take a chance. He will do that for better or for worse. Benoit with a headbutt. Benoit scoring there with that headbutt. Addled himself there. And now Benoit going for the cover. And got three. No, he didn't get three.
Oh, my gosh.
Rhino showing his tenacity.
Well, I'm going to tell you something. Raw may have really picked up a jewel right here in this Rhino. This guy is impressive, JR.
I think you're absolutely right. Arn Anderson spine buster by Rhino, just drilling Chris Benoit. Rhino has a chance tonight to become the world's heavyweight champion.
Look at Rhino.
He's got to be thinking about something special.
Oh, yes, he is. Look at that look on his face. You know what this means? He's setting up.
Rhino.
He's getting psyched up for it.
Rhino's gore could be coming. Rhino sitting in that hitting position. He's psyching himself up.
Turn around, Benoit.
And Benoit with a contact. The cross face. Benoit's got the cross face. With one of them tap. Benoit's got it locked in. And yes, Benoit cross faces his way to another victory.
Here is your winner by submission and still World Heavyweight Champion,
Chris Benoit, the reigning heavyweight champion of the world, with an ultra-hardball victory over a man that put it all on the line with one opportunity here tonight, Rhino.
Well, Rhino gets welcomed to Raw in a rude way. This is going to show you, Rhino, what the competition is like here on Raw. Rhino jumps to the core, which he's beaten many opponents with, but he winds up in that shredded Crippler crossface.
And Benoit covering a $3 stake with that Crippler crossface. You don't see Rhino tap out very often. Benoit, the world's heavyweight champion. And this crowd showing great respect for the toughest man on Raw, no doubt about it.
Sure.
Looks like the World Heavyweight Championship is safely intact around the waist of Chris Benoit. Now, Eric, as much as I want a shot at Chris Benoit, this thing between Triple H and myself, it is far from over. And in light of his trade, I see you've got one of two choices. Either trade me to SmackDown, or...
No,
I'm sorry, there's only one choice. Trade me to SmackDown and do it now.
Shawn, I'm not gonna trade you. I'm gonna go one better. I am going to be behind you 100% like never before. And let me give you an example. Raw's next big pay-per-view, Backlash. Shawn Michaels, HBK, you're going to be headlining that pay-per-view. And providing Chris Benoit and Shawn Michaels are still a part of Raw after the trade deadline, you're going to get your shot at the world title and Chris Benoit. What do you think?
I think you may have just solved my problem. Because what better way to get back at Triple H and then take the one thing that means the world to him, the World Heavyweight Championship. And for Chris Benoit, this time, one-on-one with the Showstopper.
We are on the same page.
This time, the kick, is gonna stick.
Go get him. Title.
Well, why is Flair and Batista at ringside? I mean, they're wrong. This is a SmackDown title. Look at this.
Flair and Batista trying to help Triple H steal the WWE Championship. And wait.
Hey! Look at this.
Hey, Cena. Cena and Mysterio from SmackDown.
Here we go.
Hammer away on Batista. Triple H has got the title.
Look at Flair. Going to the title. And look.
Oh, Shawn Michaels. Sweet 10 music. Sweet 10 music by Michaels. And the referee didn't see it.
Look at
Michaels with a poncho over the top.
What has Shawn Michaels done? He's knocked out Triple H. I can't believe this.
Eddie Guerrero going up top.
You got to be kidding me. Hey.
That's Christian! The referee called him for the bell!
Oh, yeah! Rob Van Dam!
Van Dam, we just joined SmackDown tonight!
RVD from SmackDown! Van Dam's sitting right in already, baby!
Look out, look at this!
What the hell?
It's all wrong!
Talk about combustible element!
But here comes SmackDown!
There we go, baby!
My God, look at the locker rooms! Raw, SmackDown locker rooms are pouring out of the gym!
On a game in the middle of the ring.
Eddie Guerrero and Triple H hammering away at one another. Still inside the ring. Look at this.
These men will escape the rules here on Raw. Raw SmackDown.
Get out there. Come on, Raw. Yeah, we need to go down there and hit Michael Collins' ass. Dukes, get him. Get him, Raw.
God, here comes Kane.
Oh, my God.
And the Big Show's right behind Kane.
Look out.
Big Show wins. Big Show. 7'5", 500-pound Big Show. Come on, he's way out here.
Lift the breaking loose here in Detroit.
Look out! My God, dear, I've never seen anything like this in my life.
It's a bar fight. It's a street fight. It's Raw versus SmackDown.
Come on, get it on, guys.
All hell has broken loose on a night we'll never forget.
Been raining here in Cincinnati all day, man.
Wait a minute.
Oh, there's Triple H just netting the Hurricane from behind. Well, we don't have to see what Triple H is going to do when he gets here.
Triple H just annihilated the Hurricane.
That's the worst weather report I've ever seen.
All the Raw superstars, as we saw, turning their back on Triple H last week when Triple H was traded to SmackDown.
Yeah, they were. That may be the worst case of professional jealousy I've ever seen. They were singing, nah, nah, hey, hey, goodbye.
See that is a message to everybody in that Raw locker room. Yeah. I saw y'all back there laughing and cheering when you thought that I was traded to SmackDown. But who's laughing now, huh? Who's laughing now? Me. You know why? Because I know for a fact that Eric Bischoff would have traded any one of you to get me back. Hell, as a matter of fact, Eric Bischoff traded three of you to get me back. And that's because Eric Bischoff is a smart businessman. He knows that if he wants to have the number one show on TV, he's got to have the number one guy. He's got to have the best if he wants to be the best. He's got to have the franchise. He's got to have the biggest star in this business today, bar none. That's why he's got to have me. You see, because Eric Bischoff knows that if Triple H is on the marquee and I'm standing in this ring, then all these seats are gonna be filled. Bischoff is a business genius because he does what's best for Raw. Unlike some other general managers, like, let's say, Kurt Angle, who does business with his ego. Let's face it, you think for 1 second Kurt Angle wanted me on SmackDown stealing his spotlight? He's still mad that I slapped him around a few years ago. Eric Bischoff does business the way it should be done. And that's why he's gonna come out here right now and he's gonna do what's right for business. He's gonna change the World Championship match between Shawn Michaels and Chris Benoit to what it should have been all along. He's gonna change that match to Chris Benoit versus Triple H for the World Heavyweight Championship.
Wow. You hear that?
I'm back, and I'm back.
Triple H, how the hell are you?
How am I? Eric, I'd tell you I feel like $1 million, but I wouldn't want to take the pay cut. You know what I mean?
I know what you mean, and quite frankly, you'd be a bargain at twice the price. And Triple H, you were absolutely right. Raw would never be the number one rated show without you. Which is why I spent all those hours on the phone with the new SmackDown general manager, Kurt Angle, and why I made the trade of Booker T and the Dudleys for you, Triple H. Hell, you know it. I would have traded the entire roster to get you back to Raw, buddy.
Wow.
Eric, that's great. Thank you very much. But what about my World Championship match?
Well, that does pose an interesting scenario. But you see, I made a verbal commitment last week to Shawn Michaels for a title match against Chris Benoit. And I can't break that commitment because, of course, it would be against the law. But I tell you what I can do. I can add to it. I can order a rematch of the greatest WrestleMania main event of all time.
Uh-oh.
At Backlash, It's going to be the final encounter. Shawn Michaels versus Chris Benoit versus you, Triple H, for the World Heavyweight Championship.
Yeah.
World Heavyweight Champion, that looking good.
You see that? See that? He's got Foley all lined up. I'm going to get the title back.
You're looking good, man.
Hell of a day. I'm telling you.
Shelton Benjamin, one of the guys who was laughing at you during the draft last night. That me?
Yeah.
Hey. What the hell was so funny last week, huh? What were you laughing at?
I asked you a question! What the hell was so funny?
You think Triple H did...
Hey!
First rule on Raw, Shelton. Never disrespect the game.
Welcome to Raw, kid.
Informed me that Ric Flair was not the legal man. Therefore, the match must continue.
Hey, now, you know what? Wait, JR. Look at that look of shock on your face, JR. He might be right about that.
Well, what about the referee's decisions are final? Marcos trying to get a handful of toss. That was a quick count right there.
I didn't see it.
That was a quick count. Oh, and that was a right hand by Shawn Michaels.
For what?
On Bischoff's apprentice. Michaels is hammering Batista.
Michaels has struck an official. He should be suspended.
And we're all taking Flair to the outside. The referee trying to fast count. That was an obvious, blatant fast count.
Disqualification!
Ladies and gentlemen, due to a disqualification, the winners and still World Tag Team Champions, Batista and Ric Flair.
Man, this decision really stinks.
What do you mean? What are you talking about? The referee did the only thing he could do. You can't strike an official.
The match should have been over. The referee's decisions are final. This is not a better call by committee.
Come on, JR. Things have got to be done right. I think the referee made a good call. Flair wasn't the legal man. He can't legally lose the match. For that disrespect, Shawn Michaels kicked the World Tag Team Championships out of the ring.
I thought Michaels and Benoit had won the World Tag Team title instead of this huge crowd here tonight in Cincinnati.
Michaels wasn't so full of himself, trying to punch the referee's lights out. I think Michaels is jealous of Nitro's hair.
This whole thing reeks of... Wait. Hey. Michaels grabbing Johnny Nitro by the hair. And
see, I told you. I knew what it was.
What was it?
Nitro's got better looking hair than Shawn Michaels.
Oh, it's not about hair.
Hey!
It's about a hit from cross face. And look at Johnny Nitro tap him like a drunk man.
Get help! And look at Shawn Michaels.
Michaels enjoying watching Johnny Nitro be tortured by Chris Benoit.
And look at that smile on your face, JR. You're enjoying it as well.
I'd enjoy it a lot better if the original decision would have stood. And those two men would have left here as the new World Tag Team Champions. We're back live, folks.
Listen, Chris.
Shelton. I know. SmackDown is the past. This is Raw. You know, I gotta tell you, I'm damn proud of you for standing up for yourself against Triple H tonight. Uh-huh. Everyone calls him the Cerebral Assassin. Yeah, he's great at playing head games, but it's also his greatest weakness, his ego. I want you to go out there and show him what you're about, who you're about. He told me I'd never be able to do it, and I made Triple H tap out. Now it's your time. You go out there, you show Triple H where you come from, what you represent. Go out there and do it. Show that you are the man and he isn't the man. All right?
Got it.
Take it to him. Take it to him.
Got it.
Hey, Shelton. Do us all a favor tonight. Take Triple H down.
Got it.
Come on, man. Do it. Hey. On Raw, you don't get a second chance to make a first impression. Now, I've seen you on SmackDown prove yourself week in and week out. Yeah. Tonight's main event, you get a chance to do it here. It's your time, man.
You're damn right.
Yeah!
You are the franchise, brother. The franchise. You are the gate. I want everybody in that locker room to be standing and learning a lesson about respect. Woo! You are the game! The franchise! Sheldon Benjamin, come on, man!
Triple H, yes. Sheldon Benjamin are next live!
I think Triple H has really underestimated this kid.
Triple H's head bouncing off those steps, and Sheldon Benjamin gonna take a chance.
Make him pay! Make him pay! Make him pay! Make
him pay! Body count it! Ben with the clothesline! From the top! Will it be? Yes! What a near fall. 2-7/8, and Triple H is in big trouble.
I cannot believe what I'm seeing here. I can't believe my eyes. Who would have ever thought this?
Benjamin's hand with the right hands. Win, lose, or draw. Benjamin has made a name for himself. Oh, man. That could be it right there. Triple H talking trash to the Sheldon Benjamin. One thing to beat a guy up, another thing to narrate it.
Okay, I think I see the look on Flair's face. Maybe things are well in hand now. All right, I'll give Benjamin credit. He's made a name for himself. He's done well here tonight, but that's enough.
Power slam!
I said that's enough!
Triple H, the power slam! Hold up! Oh, what an athletic move. That power slam came out of nowhere by Sheldon Benjamin.
Oh, game! Come on! Oh, yes!
Down here. How about this kid on it? Called the roll up! Oh, another near fall! This match, I mean, if it was on points and it's not, Benjamin in my book would be well ahead.
Flair, shout some encouragement. Give him some pointers. Do something out there.
Sheldon Benjamin wants this match. He wants it. You can feel it. Oh, you can see
it. Look at Flair.
Look at Flair. Teeth shot. Damn it.
Flair's like money in the bank.
Flair just with that right hand. And I cannot believe that the difference in this match may be Ric Flair's right hand.
Stay in your corner, Benoit. You leave Nate alone.
Benoit's
the bully of this.
Oh, splash in the corner. And the roll up. The cradle will it. No! Oh, my God. Oh, my God. What?
Here is your winner, Sheldon Benjamin.
My God almighty. Boom. Sheldon Benjamin.
This is not right.
Has just pinned the game.
That didn't happen, did it?
Well, we all know that Triple H is a big money player.
No.
Tonight, King, this was all about the Benjamin. Sheldon Benjamin. Sheldon Benjamin has come to Raw and has just beat the game.
I cannot believe it. I still can't believe it.
And, makes for a great story, doesn't it? Makes for a an amazing, amazing story. His young punk kid comes over from SmackDown.
These people are, they're like Shelton Benjamin. They're disrespecting the game. Don't do that, people, please. Yeah.
This young punk kid comes over from SmackDown in the draft. What's his name? Oh, hell, it doesn't matter what his name is. He comes over here, and in his first match, live on Raw, this young punk kid gets the lucky break of a lifetime. He gets in the ring with the greatest professional wrestler alive today. And he wins. He does the impossible. He gets his hand raised. 1, 2, 3. It's a great story. It is. But the fact is, this is reality, and it is nothing but a fluke. A fluke that could not happen again in a million years.
He's right about that, JR.
And more importantly, let me tell you about something else that can't happen again in a million years, and that is Chris Benoit walking out of Backlash with the World Heavyweight Championship belt around his waist. Yeah, that's right. I'm talking about the rematch of the century. The greatest main event in the history of WrestleMania. One more time.
I guess he sort of did tap out in a way. In a way, well, sort of.
I'm gonna put up with that for now. The rematch of all time, the final encounter, Chris Benoit, Shawn Michaels, and the game, triple threat for the World Heavyweight Championship. And if I know Chris Benoit right about now, he's starting to feel the pressure. He's feeling the pressure of having that target on his back. He's feeling the weight of the world of being the champ. And let's face it, Benoit, you are in the same position I was in. You find yourself in a match where you don't even have to get beaten to lose your world championship. And let's face it, Benoit, lose you are going to do. Chris Benoit, the odds of you winning that triple threat match in the first place were huge. The odds of you winning two triple threat matches back to back are unbelievable. The odds of you winning two triple threat matches with a legend and an icon like Shawn Michaels in it, those odds are astronomical. And the odds of you winning two triple threat matches back to back with me in it, that is impossible. So Chris Benoit, at Backlash,
Triple H. I don't mean to interrupt you, but I just wanted to come out here and introduce myself to you. I'm that young punk kid from SmackDown. No, is that getting through? Doesn't ring a bell? The All-American from Minnesota. Still doesn't ring a bell, does it? Okay, let's try this. I'm the guy that beat you just last week. One,
1, 2, 3. Oh.
And I hear y'all here. You refer to my victory as, well, a fluke. So I figured, maybe it was.
Maybe.
But I figure, if it was a fluke, I can't live with that on my conscience. So what I decided to do is come out here to challenge you to a rematch.
What?
Right here. What? In Houston, Texas.
What? Is he crazy?
Rematch.
Oh, that smile. A lot of confidence in this young man.
Wow, you are getting way ahead of yourself here, kid. Way ahead of yourself. You got this straight. You think you have one lucky moment and you think you can just walk out here and stand in the same ring as the game, huh? And not only that, then you think you have the right to walk out here and challenge me to a match? I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. You want a match right here tonight, huh?
That's right.
I'm gonna do you a favor. No.
No?
Now, let me explain to you why. You see, I'm doing you a favor, kid, because the fact is, you could build an entire career on what you did last week. You could build an entire career on the fact that you got lucky enough to beat the game. Because, Jack, nobody beats me.
That's right. Quit while you're ahead, Jack. His name is Sheldon Benjamin.
Oh.
Correction. I did. So you think I don't have a snowball's chance in hell of beating you again? I can understand what you're saying. I mean, I'm no Triple H, but I can imagine what would happen if I were someone like you. World champion time after time to get beaten twice by a young punk kid.
Wow. All right, gentlemen, let's make this short and sweet. I'm gonna teach you to defy my power. Next week from Chicago, right here on Monday Night Raw, you three are gonna team up with a man, and I don't give a damn if they have to bring him to the ring on a stretcher. You're gonna team up with Shelton Benjamin and face all four members of Evolution.
Whoa! Wow, Chicago, look out. Is that punishment, King?
Well, of course it is. 4-on-4, that's who would relish the fact that they got to face
wait,
Evolution?
Wait a minute.
No, he can't. Oh, wait a minute, hey! There's Batista, Randy Orton, and there comes Flair. These guys have come through the crowd. Evolution has come from the other side of the arena. And oh my God, what a spinebuster on Shawn Michaels. Oh, the guy had broken Michaels' back. Yeah, but Morton took... Orton and Foley going over the top rope. And now the game is in the ring and the game has that sledgehammer.
The game has that sledgehammer.
Look at Michaels. Oh, Michaels right in the spine. My God, no, King. Michaels, man, his vertebrae really cracked there. Can't believe what I'm seeing here.
Top block
by Flair, that sledgehammer. Flair with a top block on Benoit and Batista. Absolutely manhandling Mick Foley.
You had the audacity to ask him facing that.
Oh, RKO on the floor. RKO on the floor by the Intercontinental Champion. He's ripping off Foley's original flannel shirt, too. My God, this is carnage. This is Texas-sized carnage.
Well, does this show you? Is facing all four members of Evolution punishment or what?
No! A steel chair! Shawn Michaels, he has not budged, he's not moved, he's motionless since he got that sledgehammer in the back of his spine.
Man, if Michaels' back is not broken, I'll be the most surprised man in Texas.
No!
Don't do this!
Pedigree on a steel chair!
And Ross' face bouncing off that steel chair like a rubber ball. It was flesh and bone on that steel chair. And the world's heavyweight champion, along with Mick Foley.
Was WrestleMania 20, the biggest stage of them all. Some have said that it was the greatest match of all time. And now at Backlash, it'll become the greatest rematch of all time. The final encounter. Chris Benoit, Shawn Michaels, Triple H for the World Heavyweight Championship. Three of the greatest of all time, all with something to prove. Benoit will try to prove to the world that he is more than just a one-hit wonder. Shawn Michaels will try to prove to the world that he is still the icon. And Triple H, I will prove that that World Heavyweight Championship still belongs to me. Guys, there is a reason that they call me the game. There is only one diamond in this business. And you're looking at him.
After the triple threat match at WrestleMania 20, people said it was the greatest match in WrestleMania history. And as I walked the streets, people said, HBK, how are you gonna top that? How are you gonna top that? I'm the showstopper. It's what I do. Always have and always will top that. Come Backlash, three guys believe honestly in their hearts that they're the best, the very best. But that can only be true for one of us. So now it's time to separate fact from fiction. Because only one of us can walk out the world heavyweight champion.
Review. WrestleMania 20 was definitely the biggest night of my career. The night I faced a world champion. The night I faced two of the greatest wrestlers in the entire history of this business. The night I made Triple H tap out. Oh, I heard it all too. Chris, you'll never do it. Chris, you got lucky. Well, I don't believe in luck. I believe in hard work. Once you step into that ring, the only person that you can rely on is yourself. And at Backlash, it's gonna be about myself. It's gonna be about my hard work. It's gonna be about my title. And I will still walk away World Heavyweight Champion. And luck will have nothing to do with it.
Oh, look at this. Speaking of it, breaking it down.
Man, he takes a pick of that shell like it was a sack of oats. And now, the 320 pounder again. That side of that foot, right in the abdomen.
Just grinding right into the ribcage. Maybe a little lower.
Batista is a powerhouse. How do you defense that? Knees right to the, again, a straight forward No frills attack by Batista. Smash mouth wrestling here.
That ain't gonna work, Punk.
What a shot that was!
Oh no!
Man, what a shot that was by Benjamin!
Get up, Batista!
Maybe Shawn bought himself a little time.
Suck it up, Batista! Tag out!
Shawn's body's gotta be aching.
And his head's starting to bleed.
Shawn trying to make a tag. Shawn needs to make a tag.
He doesn't even know where he's at, JR.
Benjamin's gotta make a tag. And every man in Benjamin's corner ready to accept, just like Evolution. And it's gonna be.
Here comes Orton!
Orton got the tag.
Here comes Orton, here comes.
And Shawn Michaels got the tag. Orton and Michaels. Michaels and Orton.
The showstopper trying to put a stop to this right now.
Michael, the right hand of Flair and Triple H. But it's Shawn Michaels and Randy Orton.
Body
drop on the Intercontinental Champion.
Oh no!
An inverted Sonic drop on Triple H. Another on the Nature Boy. The showstopper is stealing the show here.
Oh, Michaels is on fire. This is bad.
This is a backlash emotional night.
Oh.
And Michaels flying forearm. Yes, the nip up. Oh my God, Batista.
That nip up and the knockdown.
Good.
That was brutal.
What a clothesline. Almost be hitting Michaels. This thing is degenerating in a hurry here.
Yes, it is.
Look at him. Oh, Benjamin. With a big splash in the corner door. HBK long enough to get that kick to the face, but it's Orton's RKO that has taken Shawn Michaels down.
Come on, Randy. Roll over, reach over.
The Intercontinental Champion Orton is going to win it here. There's a cover. Benoit from the top. The headbutt. Benoit putting his own carcass on the line.
He drove his hand right into the back of the skull of poor Randy Orton. Now, there you go.
He had the other way, Triple H over the top. And now Foley turns his sights on his adversary side.
And a mandible claw.
Oh, no! A mandible claw on Orton. The mandible claw on the Intercontinental Champion. Batista jerking Foley out of the ring.
God, Batista saved the day. Look at that.
Batista, difference maker here. And Shawn Michaels trying to fight back up. And Batista beat the hell out of each other on the outside. Oh, what a match. What a night.
I've never seen anything like this. Look at Randy.
Michaels back to his feet.
Watch it.
In the corner of Benoit, Michaels, Benjamin, and Foley.
Don't tell me that Shawn Michaels is going to win the triple threat match in Backlash and become the world champion.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there's Benoit. He'll go home to prove that maybe he's the best. There is, the best there was, the best there ever will be. Michaels wants the world title. Triple H is in that same picture. He believes he's the man. Evolution has lost the battle tonight, kid. But who will win the war Sunday at Backlash?
Oh, my God. What a night it's going to be Sunday at Backlash.
The world title on pay-per-view Sunday.